want to say thank you to all of you, not just for volunteering for the campaign, not just for your commitment to making sure that Jason Lewis is a one-term congressman, but mostly for sharing your stories over the last year, year and a half with me. That has really shaped this campaign in 2018 and in 2017, and it's really shaped me as a candidate. And I think the biggest difference between me and Jason Lewis on so many levels is I want to represent the struggles of Minnesota families. And Jason Lewis thinks he already knows everything, and that's why he doesn't need to listen to his constituents. Did you hear him on Esme Murphy last weekend?
Yeah. Yeah.
The people of this district already know where I stand. And I don't have to listen to them, therefore. That's the end of that sentence. Think about that for a minute. Well, here's what I've learned over the last year and a half just listening to all of you. What I've learned is that while you may have a job and the economy may be recovering, your wages haven't gone up. Not to the extent that your costs have, that your health care costs have, that your grocery costs have, that your prescription drug costs have. That's what I've heard from you. What I've heard from you is that we have a public health epidemic. And I already know this, but you've shared your stories of family members who are addicted, or the family members you've lost, who've lost their battles with addiction, particularly opioid addiction. What I've heard from you are gun violence stories. Gun violence stories that make me want to say and sit down with my Republican colleagues when I'm a member of Congress to say, listen, listen to the stories of Minnesota 2's families. What I've heard from you are the needs that you have for your special needs kids. The wonderful teachers who every single day work their butts off to make sure not only that they're safe, but they have exactly what they need to learn. Meanwhile, teachers are just getting darts thrown at them every single day in your jobs. We're making it more and more difficult for you. What I've heard from you is that we have to do better from a healthcare perspective. We have got to move this country forward to make sure that every American has quality, affordable health care, and that we're not leaving anybody behind, that it's got to become a human right to have health care in this country. What I've heard, to all of you is the fight's not over for equality. The fight is not over, not in Minnesota and not in many other places. What I've heard from you is that you need me to stand up for your family. And we have to keep moving forward together. That's the biggest difference between me and Jason Lewis. While I've been listening, Jason has been acting. And here's what he's been doing. It's no longer his words that are offensive. We're running against his record in Congress this time. His record of voting for a tax bill that gives huge corporations tax breaks and at the same time increases health costs for Minnesota families. Against a tax bill that gives big corporations tax breaks, and many of you are going to see temporary cuts and then your taxes go up. Jason Lewis has voted against health care for our families. He's voted to take it away literally from millions of Minnesotans and Americans. This is not a person who's fighting for Minnesota families. This is a person who's arrogant enough to think that he already knows what we need. And I can tell you this, Washington doesn't know what we need. We know what we need. We need better jobs, higher wages, more job skills, more investment in public education, more investment in bringing down the cost of higher education. We need affordable health care. We need to fight to make sure that Dreamers are able to stay in this country that is theirs. That's what we need in this country. Yeah. We need equality for all. We need common sense gun violence prevention measures. That's what we need. We need things that are actually going to make our kids safer and our families more secure in this country. I'm running for Congress because of your stories, because of the things that you told me are important to you. And because our values align, I'm not looking to go to Washington. I'm looking to come home and tell you what we've done to make your life better in Minnesota. And I'll vote for or against any bill that does that, regardless of party, now and in the future. Now I just